So this is a continuation of the application of EMF of measurement which we had done in our previous class. So so what are the different application we have already seen? We have seen the calculation of thermodynamic quantity of cell reaction. We have seen the calculation of free energy of, that is delta G of the cell reaction. We have seen the calculation of the equilibrium constant, determination of pH using hydrogen electrode, calculation of pH by quinhydron electrode, and the last class I did determination of pH using glass electrode. And then we also saw the what are the merits and demerits of glass electrode. Glass electrode can easily be used in the lab. It is very convenient. It can be used for oxidizing agent and reducing agent. But what is its disadvantage? Its disadvantage is it's very, very delicate. Okay, since it is extremely delicate, that's the reason the bottom of the glass electrode mostly tends to break down. And another advantage of the glass electrode is whether there is a poison or there is a metal ion, the glass electrode does not get affected. The bottom of the glass electrode is made up of very, very delicate glass, which acts as a diaphragm or a semipermeable membrane and allows the movement of the ions through them. Now, the last thing which I could not finish in the previous classes, determination of solubility product, KSP of silver chloride. So today we are going to start with this one. So what is the KSP? Okay, KSP is equilibrium constant for of the solubility product. Remember our first semester we did inorganic salt analysis, common ion effect, solubility product. Okay, so in that what we were doing is we were having some salts which were not completely soluble. Okay, they were not completely soluble, they were partially soluble. Because they were partially soluble, they were precipitating out. Since they were precipitating out, that's the reason because of the common ion effect, you could distinguish which ion, whether cation or anion, is present in the respective double salt. Okay, so now let us see how we can calculate the value of the KSP, that is equilibrium constant for a partially soluble salt. Sparingly soluble means very, very mildly it is soluble. It never makes a completely clear solution. It will make a turbid solution. Turbid means like two drops of milk in a glass of water. Okay, how does it look? It looks translucent. So it's never transparent. Okay, translucent, opaque, turbid. Like that it makes the salt solution. Okay, let's take one example here. We are having silver chloride in KCl, which is in connection with the salt bridge. Salt bridge is having saturated ammonium nitrate. And then on the right hand side, we have an electrode, silver nitrate dipped in silver. You observe here, left hand side also we have silver electrode, right hand side also we have silver electrode. But what is happening at the anode? Anode always undergoes oxidation. Oxidation is always loss of electron. So here Ag is breaking down to give Ag positive plus electron. This electron is moving from here to the other electrode, that is silver nitrate. And here what is happening? The Ag positive, which is there in the solution, is accepting the electron and getting absorbed on the silver. So silver electrode. So here at anode, Ag positive is forming. At cathode, silver is forming. So slowly, slowly, what is happening? The anode is getting deteriorated, or it is getting shredded down, or it is getting corroded. And here, silver is increasing on the cathode side. The silver electrode is having composition of silver, which is settling on top of it. So the complete cell reaction, when I take left hand side, right hand side, I have to cut the electron. So I will get Ag plus Ag positive, reversible gives Ag positive plus Ag. Okay, here K equilibrium, that is the equilibrium constant of this reaction. Which reaction? This cell reaction is equal to what? The concentration divided by 0.01 molar. What is 0.01 molar? In the starting I had taken 0.01 molar of silver nitrate solution. So concentration by 0.01 molar. If you remember, children, the same thing we did in Paul Roche's law or Ostwald's dilution law. Okay, in Kolodoschis law or Ostwald's dilution law, the same expression we had used. So from there only we are using this one only. C is what? C is the concentration of silver ion in KCl solution. This solution, this solution, KCl solution. And here, what is E naught? E naught is equal to zero because anode as well as cathode, both of them are made up of silver. Because both of them are made up of silver, the standard electrode potential of the cell is equal to zero. So what will be our K equilibrium? By substituting it in our Nernst equation, we have E is equal to E naught minus 0.0591 by N log of K equilibrium. Okay. Since E naught is equal to zero, so what is E equal to? Minus 0.059. And what is N? How many electrons are being given out? One electron, no? So 0.059 by 1 is equal to 0.0591 log of C by 0.01. Okay. So here what we can do, by taking this one, we can actually find out our E value. So E value is what, children? Here E is equal to 0.0591 log of C by 0.01 at 25 degrees Celsius. By this measurement, we can calculate the EMF of the cell. Now, what is concentration? Concentration is equal to how much of Ag positive is present. So, if I get the EMF, then I can calculate the concentration. And by knowing the concentration, I can get the F, that is Ag positive. Now, what will happen to the concentration of Cl negative? Suppose Cl negative is equal to F dash. By the similar formula, I can calculate the value of Cl negative also. So, total solubility product KSC is equal to what? S which you got from Ag positive and S dash which you got from Cl negative. So, S into S dash is equal to KSC, equilibrium constant solubility product. Okay, by this formula, you can calculate by this one. EMF you can calculate, and by knowing EMF you can do calculate the concentration first of Ag positive, then of Cl negative, and then by multiplying both of them you get the KSP value. Okay, this was the last application of the EMF. Now next we come to potentiometric titration. Actually each and every person knows how to do the potentiometric titration because we have done two titration in our lab, that is strong acid, strong base, HCl versus NaOH, and weak acid versus strong base, that is acetic acid versus NaOH. So basically, potential means what? Potential. Potential means what? Potential means the movement of the ion. The potential of an electrode depends on the concentration of the ion which is placed. So here basically we are doing the titration in which we are calculating the potential of the solution. Okay, basically these potentiometric titration are of three types: acid base titration, oxidation reduction titration, and precipitation titration. Acid base titration already you have done, we will revise that. Oxidation reduction titration and precipitation titration you have not done, okay, but we will study. So talking about acid base titration, what you will be having, you will be having on the right hand side the calomel electrode, and you will be having a standard hydrogen electrode. Two half cell will be there that will be connected with the help of salt bridge. In the burette, you will be having a standard alkali solution, and in the beaker, you will be having the acid solution. There will be a stirrer. In our lab, we didn't have stirrers, so we were using a glass rod, and you people were stirring it continuously. And this is connected to a potentiometer, which will continuously tell you the value of the means number of ions, that is the potential in the solution. So how can we calculate the EMF of the cell? Again, children, be confident. You people have done it in your lab record. E is equal to E right minus E left. What was the right hand side? Calomel. What was the left hand side? Hydrogen electrode. Calomel value at 25 degrees is a constant, you know, 0.2422 plus, and hydrogen electrode is also 0.0591 pH. Okay, by this you can calculate the EMF of the cell. Okay, and then remember the plotting of the graph. You can find out the end point in three manners. Okay, first by plotting the EMF by volume of NaOH. This is for which one? A weak acid versus a strong base. So weak acid versus a strong base means slowly the graph will increase, and drastically at the end point the graph will increase.
When it becomes vertical, you just drop a line, and that point is known as your endpoint. And then afterwards, once the endpoint is reached, after that again the graph will become constant. If suppose this is not clear, we can do the same graph by using delta E by delta V. What is delta E? Change in the EMF upon change in the volume. Okay, mostly if you remember, we had used 0.5, 0.5, 0.5 volume, so that was being used. And we have to draw a graph with volume of NaOH. Then there will be a peak. The highest peak will be your endpoint. If suppose this is also not clear, you can actually square this delta E square by delta V square and then draw the graph. And then again you will get one peak and a drop, and that is your endpoint. Mostly all these three values will be identical. They will be same. Okay. So in this manner, you can calculate for the acid-base titration. Okay, acid-base titration, you can use strong acid versus strong base, weak acid versus strong base, strong acid versus weak base, weak acid versus weak base. All the four types, you can do it. Now let's talk about a redox titration. Again, what is reduction? Reduction is gain of electron. What is oxidation? Oxidation is loss of electron. Here we are taking a ferrous Fe2 positive getting converted to Fe3 positive and Ce4 positive getting converted to Ce3 positive. So Fe2 positive to Fe3 positive means it's accepting one electron. Since it's accepting one electron, it is what? It is undergoing a reduction. Reduction is gain of electron. Here cerium-4 positive is becoming a ceric-3 positive. So what it is doing? Ce4 positive to Ce3 positive. Sorry, I made a mistake here. Fe2 positive is getting converted to Fe3 positive, means it is losing an electron. This is oxidation. Ce4 positive is converted to Ce3 positive, means what? It is undergoing a reduction. Okay. So here also, when we do the redox reaction, what will happen is how much concentration of Fe2 positive is being lost, the same concentration of Ce4 positive is being gained also. So the concentration of these two will be equal. Concentration of these two will be equal. Okay. And then we'll get a plot in which in the starting the EMF will increase very slowly, and immediately at end point there will be a drastic increase, and then again it will become very, very slow. Okay, this will happen. So what is the reaction here? According to our Nernst reaction, we know that E of the electrode, that is the EMF of the electrode, is equal to standard EMF of the electrode plus 0.0591 log of reduced state upon oxidized state at 25 degrees Celsius. Mostly this Fe3 positive by Fe2 positive value is around 1:10. Okay, 1:10, 1 by 10 means that is equal to what? 0.01. Okay, 1 by 10 is equal to what? 1 by 10 is equal to 0.1. Okay, 0.1. So we can calculate the E of the cell, that is equal to E0 minus 0.059. Okay. Okay. What is log of 10 to the power minus 1? Minus 1 itself. So what will happen to the sign? Sign from positive, it will get converted to minus 9. But here we have to understand that, as I told in the previous one, the amount of ferrous ion is equal to Ce4 positive. Amount of Fe3 positive is equal to Ce3 positive. Here you see this reaction. The amount of Fe2 positive is equal to Ce4 positive. The amount of Fe3 positive is equal to Ce3 positive. Okay. So by knowing this value, we can actually, in place of Fe3 positive by Fe2 positive, you can actually place Ce4 positive by Ce3 positive. Okay. This can be equated. Okay. This can be equated. So we get two values. E is equal to E0 plus 0.0591 log of Fe3 positive by Fe2 positive, the same one which we got. In place of this, we can put Ce4 positive by Ce3 positive. If suppose I add the two equations, what will I get? The 0.0591 log of Fe3 positive by Fe2 positive, 0.0591 log of Ce4 positive by Ce3 positive. This 38 and 39. What we are doing, we are adding 38 and 39. So we will get what? 2E equilibrium. Even not. Kindly mute yourself, children, please. Okay. suddenly you people will talk, no, will get.
Go no. Nadu first. Nadu first. No, Nadu. Na time ay thun Nadu. నువ్వు ఫస్ట్ నాడు అన్న నేను కిందకొస్తే ఇంకా దారుణంగా పడితే నాడు నడువు 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 నడు ఫస్ట్ నాడు నువ్వు
ఓకే హూ ఇస్ టెలింగ్ నడు 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 ఓకే లెట్స్ కమ్ బ్యాక్ సో వి హావ్ టేకెన్ ద 38 అండ్ ద 39 రియాక్షన్ And we have added both of them, so we got 2e equilibrium is equal to e1 naught plus e2 naught. Okay, so e equilibrium will be this 2 going down, so e1 naught plus e2 naught by 2. Okay, this is that. Okay, so we were talking about our ferrous getting converted into ferric and Fe4 positive getting converted into Fe3 positive. So here also, by doing this titration, we can get a graph, and with the help of the graph, you can get the endpoint, and with the help of the endpoint, actually, you can calculate the EMF of the cell by using this formula. Okay, E is equal to E1 naught plus E2 naught by 2 minus E of calomel. E of calomel is what? 0.2422, and this standard value is already known, 0.77 plus 1.61 by 2. So when we calculate it, EMF of the cell will come out to be 0.9478. Another one is the third type of potentiometric titration is precipitation titration. In precipitation titration, the endpoint will be a precipitate. For example, here we can have a standardized reaction between a silver nitrate. Silver nitrate is forming a silver chloride, which is acting as what? It is acting as a indicator. So one of the half cell will be your silver ion / silver, and another one will be what? KCl1. So here the potential of the half cell of Ag positive / Ag is measured by connecting with calomel electrode. Calomel, again mercury and mercurous chloride is there, and then in calomel you know that KCl solution will be there. So the silver nitrate will react with KCl. It will form Ag positive plus Cl negative. This is silver chloride, and K positive plus NO3, that is potassium nitrate. So what will happen to the EMF of the cell? EMF is EMF of the right plus EMF of the left. So EMF is equal to E naught plus 0.0591 log of Ag positive at 25 degrees Celsius. From where did we get this? From using the Nernst equation, we have got this one. So by knowing this formula, we can actually calculate the EMF of the cell. In the starting, what will happen? The silver nitrate is breaking down, forming a precipitate. Now, precipitate is what? Sparingly soluble. Since it is sparingly soluble, immediately the potential will start dipping down. Potential depends upon number of ions moving. No, because it is sparingly soluble, the ions are not moving around. It is not forming an ion only. It is forming a stable molecule. Since it is forming a molecule, what is happening? The potential is dipping here. That shows the endpoint. And again, once all the silver ion is used up to form AgCl, what will happen? Again, KNO3 will be there in excess. Because it will be there in excess, there will be a little bit increase in the potential. Okay, so you will get a sigmoid type of graph. By knowing this endpoint and substituting it here, you can calculate the EMF of the cell. Okay. Now, let's see few of the videos, children. This is a revision for your practicals also. We'll watch these things. Here, the potentiometric titration between K2Cr2O7 and FeSO4. Okay, just now we saw ferrous ferric and chromium thing, no? So, this is one redox type of potentiometric titration. Let's see.
Today, we are going to see the experiment potentiometric titration. The apparatus required for this experiment are a burette, pipette, potassium dichromate, ferrous ion solution, distilled water, and a funnel. For doing this redox titration, we need two major electrodes. They are calomel electrode, platinum electrode. First, we are filling the burette with potassium dichromate solution. Then, 20 ml of ferrous ammonium sulfate is pipetted into the 100 ml beaker. Then 10 ml of dilute sulfuric acid, which is a dehydrating agent, it is added to the solution. 10 ml of distilled water is also added. Then the electrodes are connected to the potentiometer. Now we shall see the experiment. Now potassium dichromate is added from the burette to the solution. We can see the increase in EMF on the potentiometer. The solution are slowly converted to iron 3 plus ions. By seeing the green color from the solution, we can identify the reaction taking place. On the potentiometer. We can note the color of the beaker. Now it is slowly intensified to dark green color.